Hey guys, how's it going? So in this video, we are taking the top performing Acer Aspire 5 laptop powered by the Intel processor and one by AMD processor, and we are going to pit these two guys against each other. So on one hand, we have the 10th generation Intel Core i5 model, and on the other hand, we have the AMD Ryzen 7 model. So which one of these two is going to come out on the top? Let's find out. So both Intel and AMD configuration of Aspire 5 sell for the same exact price. At the time of making this video, it was $650, but the price tends to fluctuate. So please check the link that I have put in the description below to find the latest price on Amazon. Okay, so here is a chart showing the key features of Aspire 5 laptop with this flagship Intel and AMD configuration. So what I have done is that I have highlighted the similarities in blue color and the differences in dark red color. So the Intel model of Aspire 5, it comes with Core i5-10210U processor, and this is the 10th generation CPU from the Comet Lake family. AMD model, on the other hand, it comes with the Ryzen 7 3700U processor. So note that the 10th generation Intel chip, this was launched at the end of 2019, third quarter of 2019, while the AMD chip was launched somewhere in the, you know, beginning of 2019. So technically the Intel chip is relatively newer to the AMD chip. So both these CPUs, they have 4 cores and 8 threads, and both these CPUs operate at the same TDP. So that's the 15 watt thermal envelope. Ryzen processor has a faster base clock frequency than the Core i5 processor, but then the Core i5 processor has the faster turbo clock frequency. Another difference is that the Core i5 has more cache than the AMD Ryzen model. So how does all this translate to real world performance? So for that, let's take a look at the CPU benchmark. So here is a single thread benchmark from Passmark software. Core i5 scores 2314 points as opposed to Ryzen 7, which scores 1842 points. So that translates to a whopping 25.6% single thread performance lead by Intel. Now let's take a closer look at the multi-threaded benchmark. So this benchmark should give us a better idea of the overall performance of both these CPU. So Intel Core i5, it is scoring 8466 points, while the Ryzen 7 scores 8006 points. So we can clearly see that, you know, the Intel model is ahead, but not by much. It's about 5.7% faster than AMD. So that means AMD has significantly narrowed the gap in multi-threaded performance, you know, benchmark. Now, what is the reason for this? So the main reason why the Intel chip is performing better in single-threaded test is because it has a higher IPC. IPC stands for instruction per cycle, and a higher value suggests that the CPU can do more work for the same clock frequency. So that's why even though AMD Ryzen has a higher base clock frequency, it's the Core i5 which is able to deliver better performance. Now note that in addition to better IPC, Intel Core i5 also has a higher turbo clock frequency. So this allows the Intel processor to automatically overclock all the way up to 4.2 GHz, and therefore it delivers better performance in short bursts of time. But you know, when you are running all the 4 cores and 8 threads and you are cranking all these cores and threads at full load, then both these CPUs perform at almost the same level. So overall, in my opinion, I think Intel Core 5 is definitely a better CPU choice. Since both these laptops cost the same money, $650, my recommendation will be to go with the Intel CPU if you are looking for, you know, the top performance. But you know, CPU is only one side of the story. Graphics performance and the system RAM also play a key role in the overall performance of the laptop. The AMD model of Aspire 5, it comes with Radeon RX Vega 10 mobile graphics. Intel model, on the other hand, it comes with the NVIDIA GeForce MX250 graphics, and this has 2 GB of dedicated video RAM. And because of this dedicated video RAM, it's a far better GPU than AMD. So let's look at G3D graphics benchmark. Intel model with NVIDIA GPU scores 2608 points, while the AMD model scores only 1664 points. So that's a whopping 56.7% performance lead by the GeForce MX250 over Radeon RX Vega 10. So, you know, for gaming, I think it's a no-brainer. You have to go with the Intel model because it has not only got the faster CPU, but it has got, you know, a significantly faster GPU. So that was for gamers, but what about non-gamers? Does it make sense to buy Aspire 5 with the Ryzen chip in any other circumstances? So, you know, to answer that question, we have to take a look at some of the other key differences between the Intel and AMD model. So the first difference, which I think is very important, is the battery life. Acer rates Intel model at 9.5 hours of battery life, while the AMD model is rated at 7.5 hours of battery life. But in real life, you can expect about 6.5 hours of battery life on the Intel model and about 4.5 hours of battery life on AMD model. So I think battery life is so important, and if you are getting 2 hours of extra battery life on Intel model, that is a significant advantage. So in my opinion, Intel wins this round as well. Now let's take a look at the port situation. There is a glaring omission of USB Type-C port on the AMD model. Intel model, on the other hand, it comes with USB Type-C Gen 1 port, and this is the 5 gig per second data transfer rate port. So that's another win for Intel in my opinion. Both these laptops, they have the same exact 512 gig of fast PCIe NVMe SSD, and both of them have 8 gig of DDR4 system RAM. The build quality of the laptops, the quality of the 15.6 inch IPS panel, the keyboard, the trackpad, they are exactly identical. Since I've already covered these aspects of the laptop in my previous review video, I'm not going to repeat myself and bore you guys. So instead, what I've done is I've created a playlist, and my playlist comprises of all my Aspire 5 related videos that I have made in the past few months, and it's linked below in the description. So feel free to check it out after you are done watching this video. First watch this video. AMD model has two DIMM slots, and both these slots are user upgradable. So that's a great thing. But unfortunately, the Intel model, it only has one user upgradable DIMM slot. So you can easily access these DIMM slots in both the laptops. All you have to do is open the back of the laptop. And if you need any help, please watch my video, which is linked below. And in this video, I show how you can open the Aspire 5 laptop and how you can upgrade both the RAM and SSD. By the way, you can add up to 16 gig of RAM in each DIMM slot. So this means that AMD model can be maxed out to 32 gig RAM. But the Intel version, it comes with 4 gig RAM that is already soldered to the motherboard, and the remaining 4 gig RAM that is sitting on the DIMM slot. So you can replace this 4 gig RAM which is on the DIMM slot with the 16 gig stick, and so that will bring up the total RAM on your Intel laptop to 20 gig. So I will drop a link to compatible memory modules which are going to work with both these laptops, and you can find them in the description below. Since AMD system can go up to 32 gig, I think it's a definite win for AMD. So if you plan to run applications which consume a lot of system RAM, like various software development programs, or if you are planning to run virtualization software, or things like Adobe Photoshop, or any application which you deem will need a lot of RAM, then I think AMD will be the better option, because you can easily upgrade and max out the system RAM to 32 gig. Okay, now let's move to the SSD storage. So both Intel and AMD models, like I said, they come with 512 gig of SSD. This is PCIe NVMe SSD, so this is really fast. Now if you are interested in adding more storage, it's actually very easy, because both these laptops, they come with SATA 3 and M.2 slot for upgrading the SSD. The M.2 slot, it's already occupied by the 512 gig SSD that is present in the laptop, but the SATA 3 slot is completely empty. So I will drop a link to compatible SATA 3 and NVMe SSDs that you can buy from Amazon if you plan to upgrade the storage in your laptop. And again, I have made a video showing step-by-step instructions on how you can add SSD to your Aspire 5 laptop. So you can check out that video below. I have linked it in the video description. So guys, here is the bottom line. Intel version of Aspire 5 laptop, the one with the Core i5 10th generation processor, I think it comes out on top in every scenario. So whether you are into gaming, or whether you are looking for a laptop, for content creation or any other productivity task, Intel is the better choice. Now there is only one scenario where the AMD model makes sense, and that's the one where you want to max out the system RAM to 32 gig. For that, AMD makes sense, because AMD model has two DIMM slots, and so you can put 16 gig of memory stick in each DIMM slot, and you can have a dual channel 32 gig system RAM configuration. And so that's going to be really great for running applications which require a lot of RAM. So like I said before, Intel model, you can only go up to 20 gig of RAM, because it has only one DIMM slot. And also, you will not be running dual channel configuration. You will actually be running single channel configuration. So that's slower memory performance. So I think if you plan to run a lot of memory intensive application, and if you cannot live without 32 gig system RAM, then absolutely go with the AMD model. But for the rest of the folks, combination of the 10th generation Core i5 processor along with the NVIDIA MX250 GPU, I think that is a far better choice than what AMD is offering. And remember, both these models are exactly the same price, $650. So you won't be saving any money by buying the AMD model. Now, if you want to save money, and if you want to go with a more budget configuration, then you should pick the AMD Ryzen 3 model. This is incidentally the best-selling laptop on Amazon, and it usually goes for about $300. So I've already made bunch of videos targeting this laptop, and I personally love this laptop. I will drop a link to this laptop in the video description below if you want to check it out. So guys, I hope you found this video useful. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section below and I will try to help you guys. Please like this video and subscribe to TechnoPanda for more videos like this. Also check out TechnoPandaReviews.com. This is the website where I have consolidated all the reviews. So you will find reviews focusing on laptops, gaming PCs, gaming laptops, you know, TVs, monitors and other gadgets. So again guys, thanks for watching my video and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye!